Hello everyone. After learning how to create a Google form and its various question types, now we are moving on to learning the Google form sections and its logic. So to basically learn this thing, I have already created one Google form, one feedback form I have already created. So the basic purpose of this feedback form is to collect the feedback from the people, from the participants. Let's say your college, your institution has organized some webinar, some seminar, and you want to collect feedback for that webinar or the seminar, right? So you are creating a feedback form for that. Now, the main purpose of this video is that to create sections. Now you will ask, why do we need to create sections, right? So sometimes, let's say when you are taking a feedback or a survey from the customers that how they feel while using a particular product or service, right? So there may be different types of information that you may be catering to. Like they can be personal information, they can be academic information, they can be professional information, right? So these are actually different types of information. So if you are professionally working on a Google form, it is always advisable to create different sections, right? Sometimes it may also happen like you have given couple of options and a person has to choose yes or no. If a person choose yes, that means the person is, you know, can be taken ahead to further sections of the form. But if the person chooses no, then there is no option of, you know, making that person fill the rest of the form. So then that's why that is the need of creating sections. I'll show you how to create sections, and while doing this practical on this Google Forms, you will understand what is the purpose of making sections. So let's start. Let's say I want to collect the feedback from the people who have attended the webinar. So first thing obviously I need is the name, right? I'll make this question as required. Next could be their email address. Google has made it as short answer. Okay, now it is giving me a suggestion. Enable email collection setting, if you can see here, right? Enable email collection setting. So if I click on this setting, what will happen that people, before filling in the form, they have to log in, right? So let's click on this option. Now I have changed the settings to collect email address, and since the Google form now is instructed to collect email addresses, so this question has been shifted on top, right? So first of all, it will ensure that the email address that the person is entering is a valid email address. Otherwise, the person will not be allowed to fill in the form. That's a very good feature of Google Forms. Okay, now let's start. Name is the first thing that you are asking. Okay, now let's say in the seminar which your institution has organized, there will be different participants. Few would be faculty, few would be students, few would be maybe corporate delegates, and maybe others, right? So obviously the faculty is having different set of details, affiliation, designation. The students have different set of details that you need to ask them. So for this purpose, we will create sections, right? So let me ask your profession. Okay, so I'm asking the recipient of this form their section. So okay, let me just scroll it down. Your section, your profession, and then I can give them multiple choice, that is they have to select only one. Say student, faculty, corporate, delegates. Okay, let me restrict myself to these three options only. Your profession, I am making this question as required. The next question that I may be asking them, if let's say the person is a student, right, then obviously there may be different set of questions that I should be asking them. If a person is a faculty, there may be different set of questions I should be asking them. So what my point is that the student should not go through, or student should not have to go through the questions which are meant for faculty. Similarly, a faculty should not have to go through the questions which are meant for students, right? So I'll create sections. Okay, so this is the icon for creating section or adding section. I'll add section. Okay, so let me make this thing clear here, that I'm creating different sections for different people who are belonging to different professions. So let's say this section is for student, right? Student's information, that if a person is a student, then he should fill this section. Now I can add questions into it, say department, or rather I can mention here course, right? And I can let this option be open, because the participants who would have come to my webinar or to our college seminar may be belonging to different colleges, institutions, and they may be having different sort of courses. So let them write this answer on their own. So no drop down list is created this time. Another thing I can ask them is year, right? For year, obviously I can create questions, or I can create multiple choices. Why? Because year can be limited. Obviously, if it's a student, then maximum year that the person can have is 4 years or 5 years. If the person is doing a 4 year undergraduate course, so the maximum figure that can go up to is fourth year. So first year, second year, third year, and fourth year. Similarly, I can make this also as the required one, right? So this is the section for students. Now, since I'm collecting feedback, so I can ask them any suggestions or comments that you wish to give, please write. Since the suggestions or comments can be long, so paragraph, question type is the suitable. However, you can leave this option or leave this question as not required, because sometimes people may not want to comment, or sometimes people do not want to suggest anything. So you can leave this question as not required. So that means a person can submit the form even without submitting this question. Okay, so this was the section created for students. Now let me create another section for the faculty. So section 3, I can name it as faculty's profile, faculty's information. Let me write it like this, faculty's information. I can add questions to it. So first question that I can ask the faculty is the designation, right? So designation, it can be a short answer, and I can make it required. Department, right? Short answer, I can make it required. Now the next question I want to ask them is again the same, any suggestion or comments that you wish to give, please write. This is the same question that I have asked from students. I want to ask the same question from the faculties also, right? So one thing I can do, I can type here the same thing, any suggestion or comments you wish to give. Or what I can do, I can copy this question. I can make a duplicate copy of this question, duplicate, right? The two questions are created. It's the same duplicate question, right? With the same features that I have switched on while making the question. So what I can do, I can just move this question to the bottom of my page, to the place I want it to be placed, right? So by using this cursor, this arrow, I can take it down wherever I want. I want it below the department, so I have placed it there. So it is placed here, right? So next question, maybe I don't wish to ask any other question. I can delete this. Then the next section which I can create is for the corporate delegates, right? Corporate delegates information. I can ask them the question like designation / department. I can make this require. I can ask them name of the organization, right? And I can make this as required. And I want to ask again the same question, any suggestion, comments that you wish to give. So I can duplicate the question and I can move the question to the bottom of the page, right? And can place it here. So now, as you can see, I'll show you the preview of this form.